Listen, girl. You do not interfere.
I am not done yet.
It's just been a few days since you came here. And you dare raise your voice against me? You saved her from my wrath, but this time you won't be able to.
I tolerated your first slap. That's because she tried to interfere in your family matters. But next time, don't ever repeat this mistake. Not today, nor tomorrow, nor in future. Are you crazy? Why did you interfere in family matters? Remember, you are new to this house. You might stay here for a few more days. It's not a permanent stay. Keep your mouth shut. Nobody cares what you think. She's my aunt, not my mother. If left to you, you would spill the beans that you are from Veerpur. The matter would have got out of hand. Why did you interfere?
I had a reason. Maybe you don't realize that. But I can see how your aunt is making your sister-in-law's life miserable. She is insulted time and again. She is always chided. You can see my mistake. But you can't see your sister-in-law's plight or her troubled life. Not a single day has passed in which she didn't shed tears.
She is not your sister.
But she's a sister-in-law.
No, she is not. I don't consider her as my sister-in-law. I have no relation with these people. Also remember that we are related in no way. Enough of this drama. This is not affection. I lied just to save your life. Stop believing that lie. And listen, stop building relation with these people. I'll remind you if you forget. This is not your house.
Then where is my house? Tell me, from where did you bring me? Where do I belong? Where is my village? Where is my family? What about my relatives? What is my identity?
Go to Sunari's room. Right now. Don't ever argue with that woman again. I'll not be here to protect you every time. Understood? You should have got that slap. At least you wouldn't have crossed your limit.
Then you should have let her slap me. Why did you intervene?
What are you doing here?
Well, there's a wound on your face. So I got an ointment. Whenever brother-in-law or I used to get too wounded, Aunt used to apply.
And you assumed that I would let you apply it?
No. That is why I got it when you were asleep. It will burn a little but will heal soon.
The wounds inflicted by a woman doesn't hurt. I have learned to bear them. Go away.
If you feel like using it or if it hurts more, please apply it. And if it burns too much, then keep repeating honeybee. That will get your mind off the burning sensation.
Why are you doing all this? Did you forget that I am the same monster who killed your fake husband in front of you? Why are you concerned about me?
Because I was supposed to get that wound. But you saved me. I am not fond of living anymore. But I don't want to die every moment thinking that I owe you a favor. You are a monster, but that doesn't mean that I should treat you badly. As how different would that make me from you? One more thing. I know that you think I am wrong. and that I am pretending to be truthful. But let me say this again, that I'm not wrong. I would neither go against my people or my country, nor would I let anybody do so. I am innocent. Sooner or later, you will learn the same.
Where did you find that smile of yours? Tell me, so that even I could get some for me.
It's gone. There were just one or two left. It ran away as soon as I took your name.
Brother-in-law, this isn't the place to show off your cleverness. I know you very well, that you and Rudra have come here with some purpose.
It's time for me to go to the bed. I don't want to argue with you.
Before you go to sleep, please make your son understand that he needs to control his fiancé. She better not interfere in our family matters.
As far as I remember, your speech and Rudra's hearing both are in order. Why don't you tell him yourself? On the second thought, are you afraid of him? That he might oppose you again adamantly, right?
Rudra Pratap Ranawat might be a revered BSD officer, but you don't know me at all. Even I have very good contacts.
You have very good contacts, right? How many people do you know? Do you know them all? Here's an idea. Show your influence and make it rain. It's getting really hot over here. There shall be some relief.
You speak of rain, but I can bring thunderstorms. Then don't complain later that you were not warned by me.
Sister-in-law, how is Brother Rudra?
He's all right.
Well, sister-in-law, I must say that you are very much in love with my brother Rudra. This is for the first time I saw someone getting slapped for the sake of their fiancée. Your beauty surely has done the trick. But sister-in-law, tell me, how did you guys meet for the first time?
In my dreams, I used to dream about him every night, all my life. He used to wake me up by scaring me.
Oh, did he visit you in dreams? These dreams are amazing, sister-in-law. Even I dream a lot of my prince riding on a horse. He's coming to take me. Well, sister-in-law, why did you say that he scared you in your dreams, when you actually meant that he was cajoling you?
Tell her the truth. Tell her how he has destroyed your life. Tell her that her brother is a cruel person.
Sister-in-law, brother Rudra was bleeding. Then he got slapped for your sake.
I'm feeling very sleepy. Let's get some sleep.
Okay, get some sleep. I was just bringing tea for you.
I don't want it.
But why not?
Sister-in-law, may I help you? Are you still worried about last night? I'll definitely try to explain to Aunt. Maybe...
No, Parvati. I don't need your help. I'm fine, the way I am.
Sister-in-law, are you angry at me? If you're hurt by anything I said to you, I apologize to you. But please don't ignore me like this. If you get angry at me, then who will I talk to?
Parvati, I have a lot of work to do.
Did you learn your lesson? I told you, explained to you. Stop making relations, there is no use. They are nothing but trouble. Just avoid them. Why are you upset now? Anyway, you're not going to stay here forever.
Have some laddu. Please have.
Take some more.
Come on, have it. Here, have some sweets. Hey, brother-in-law. Here, brother-in-law, have some sweets. If you don't have sweets today, then who else will? Take it.
Hey, brother Rudra. Take it. It's for you too. Have it now. I'm giving it after tasting it, so that you can be assured that it's not poisoned.
I don't eat sweets.
Wonderful. Mom, you told me that whenever you see my face or my mother's, you need to have some sweets. Right? So why not now?
Come on, take it. Have more sweets.
Mohini.
Please take it.
What new drama is this?
Drama, brother-in-law? I didn't expect this from you. How could you forget today's date? Today is a very special day. The day after which your life was changed.
Tell me clearly what you want to say.
Well, actually it's so painful, brother-in-law, that no matter how it is said, it's difficult to be clear. But still, as you wish. Well, you guys have had the sweets. Now let me tell you what the occasion is. Today, my sister-in-law, the eldest daughter-in-law, and brother-in-law Dilshad's wife, it's her birthday. I feel very sad to say that she's not among us. No, there's no such thing. May she live for 1,000 years. She's still alive. But she left her husband and her son and she ran away. I mean to say, she's gone.
Enough!